we decided, your first thing was elements, the first year. So the name that pops up most on the board, even though it's a small circle, is elements. There's four elements. You can subgroup it every year, do something different. But if we have it every year, elements, people will know it's the elements festival. Most festivals, if you look all over the country, they've got a theme. People know what they're getting every year. They do something smaller, different, small, new, whatever. Mm-hmm. But they know what they're going to. What else was there? Also, what she said, like, if you've got something that you've got every year, like elements, it's easier to get sponsorships. That whoever it relates to, that topic, whatever, to businesses or whatever, to get sponsorships, instead of chopping, changing every year.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. People know what it's about. The last 2 years I was at the festival, I didn't know there was themes. Neither did she. A few people didn't know there was themes.
I didn't know what the theme was last year at all, and I was like in the thick of
so
that sounds really bad, I apologize. Maybe it was just my ignorance. Maybe, you know.
No.
And then the other thing we thought with elements is it's a very nice way to kind of group things when you talk about, for example, the boxes, the recycling, that all falls under earth. When you have your dance projects and your speakers and your singers, that kind of falls under fire and passion. And then you've also got a massive pool with water because we have a whole other water group. And same with wind, we thought was quite kind of arty because it flows and it's free. So we thought it was quite nice for like the program. I remember I had the coffee shop where people would come in, we had programs, people would be like, what does this mean? Like how does it work? And I think it would be quite nice to be able to give each element a colour, and break things like the program, break areas down. So when you have a thing on, it can be like, okay, if it's fire, it's red, a red area, red on the program. Mm-hmm. So that it just becomes easy to understand for outsiders who haven't done anything with the planet. Because I think it needs to be as simple as possible for people to be able. People want to understand things if they're going to be on board. You know, and it needs to be. Mm-hmm. As easily explained as possible. That was my kind of thought process on it from an organizational point of view.
Any comments to that? Anyone want to feedback on the thing? Or?
Can I just ask a question? So if you've got the four elements, additional elements that you want to introduce, would you then rotate them every 4 years?
You can subtitle every year. It's just that people know it's the Elements Festival, like the Pink Lurie Festival, they know it, that's what they're going for. Yet, Musaberg, we all about nature. We've got the most beautiful spot in the country. It's all about nature. It's the four elements.
I mean, that did come up.
So would it be the Musaberg Elements Festival? Is that
what you suggested? I mean, it doesn't even need to be as kind of out there as that. It doesn't need to be in the title. Mm. It can just be...
this time it's focusing on water.
Yeah.
This time
and we didn't do a massive amount of discussing of like, okay, this is the fire festival, because I think that, again, it then kind of thins it out again, because people are like, okay, it's a fire festival this year, it's a water. You'd really need to pump the elements thing every year to make sure people knew that was the thing they were going for. But if you had all four, I just feel for I always just remember being like, okay, so this is happening here, this is happening here. If we found a nice way to break it down into colours and sections of activity that is going on under the four elements every year, was my thought process. We didn't really talk much about dividing one element per year, but that's another kind of way we could
think about it. Mm-hmm. Okay. Because obviously it gives you more different opportunities. But also just one thing, there's not just four elements, there's the four elements of nature, which is bringing us from classical thought. But there's lots of other elements to life besides those four elements. Those may be the four constituent elements. There's lots of other elements.
Just
water. Basically, how water is so fundamental in all sorts of facets in our life. Obviously, there's a drought going on, and how that drought has made us more aware of water and the lack of water and how we're treating water. There's talk of water as a representation of Musaberg, it's what we have, and it's celebrated. We've got the mountain, the clay, the ocean, the stream running from the mountain unused. There was then talk of how we treat water is how we're also treating ourselves. We're not treating water with respect. We don't treat each other with respect. There's a reflection in society as well, the way we treat this natural resource. The words of flow and energy, reflections, but a sentence that we came to really, really like is we are water. So that now takes the geographical, beautiful, efficient, useful. water, because the world in water, so us as humans and that connection. What's around us reflects, what's around us water cleans, healing water, and water as a meeting place as well, people meeting at a well, images like that, but also how decor-wise and incorporating into different parts of the festival will be very tangible. So whether it's decor or it's performances or it's talks and presentations, everyone can be able to draw something from the theme.
I think the one thing that we also said was that nature arts and energy and flow, so it felt like an appropriate.
So we had explosive colour and the art jamming garden boxes and iron wood that fall. So the common thread that we identified was this thing of creation. And so we thought that it could come off from last year's theme, which was Imagine Musenberg. So this is so this would be about creation, about co-creation. So that ties in with a lot of the other like parts of the Musenberg festival ethos, because everything is co. And also this idea that it's all very well imagining something, but you need to actually create it. And the idea, so making imagination visible. And what does Musenberg create? So how do we create Musenberg? How does Musenberg create us? And what does Musenberg as a whole create? And in general, somebody said that there's a great poverty of new ideas. So also about having new ideas, etc. And about yourself and Musenberg being like a microcosm within a macrocosm. But the one thing which kept coming up was co-creation. And then the idea of flow and water actually ended up linking in quite well with what we were discussing as well. Anybody else have a quick comment?
We kind of just had enough time to start looking at unlearning segregation, and we were thinking around what that means in the festival space on a practical level in terms of transportation and the stories that you tell in the festival space. There was also a question of embodiment speaking to that, being actually, I think we would be better sort of, because that was something that was very, you felt very strongly about. So when I finish, maybe you can add to that, maybe I would adequately represent it. And then towards the end of our conversation, there was a point made that the word flow seems to stick really well to, again, in the same way you said water tying everything together, the word flow really tied everything together in quite an interesting way. Also using the word fluidity, which can speak to fluidity of many different things, fluidity of identity, fluidity of environment, fluidity of transportation of people and the movement of people through space. There was a mention of that Musenberg is, I think maybe that's something that you said that I just thought came from my group, about being a migrant community and being something that is always evolving and always changing, and that's something to find an interesting way to represent. I don't want to talk too much. You had a thing about
that. Yeah, I think we really did just come down to flow, that if there is flow, then communication will happen, links will happen, we will tell our stories, we will share and get the problem is what are the blocks. So in a way, flow is great, but the thing about embodiment was, if in the parade we embody the theme, we must really show it, like really dress up to show it. The other thing I wanted to say was the stir it up thing is great, because that's the thing of the festival, is to stir it up, new paradigm, co-create. We mustn't be saying, oh, they did in history, they repeat the name. We mustn't actually look to the past, as how people do festivals. It's a new festival and new ideas, new ways. But it is a good idea to hold elements as colours and themes and flow and water wise. Water holds memory, it is wise, it is conscious, it knows everything. So sort of water wise, I know it sounds silly.